Namaste students, welcome to biology class. So in the previous session we have discussed about various chapters under the unit diversity of living world. So today let us discuss about a new chapter, that is morphology of flowering plants. So before entering into the chapter, first we'll try to understand about the term morphology, and knowing the importance of morphology, then we'll move on to the chapter, that is morphology of flowering plants. So coming to the definition of the morphology, we know that under biology, or the subject biology has got various branches. Among these, one of the branch is known as morphology. Morphology is that branch of science that deals with the size, color, form, structure of living organism. Now, morphology is the branch of science that deals with size, form, color, and external structure of organism. So we have to know the morphology of any of the living organisms. It is better to understand the morphology of any of the living organism. So there is a need for studying the morphology of organism. So we'll see what is the need or what is the importance of morphology. So I have listed down some of the importance of morphology. We have to know the morphology of living organisms. So here in this particular chapter, we are mainly dealing with the angiosperms or the flowering plants. So there is a need to study about morphology mainly for identification of organisms or identification of plants. So if we know the morphology or external features of the organism or the plants, we can identify particular plant. So morphology is essential for identification of plants. In addition to that, if we know the morphology of the plants, it forms a criteria for classification of plants. Morphology forms a criteria for classification of plants. And morphology mainly provides information about variations found among the species. You know that there are wide varieties of species of plants, or it may be any other organisms. If we know the morphology of a particular organism, we can understand or we can get the information about variations that are found among the species. Morphology mainly helps us to understand about various aspects of plant. You know that plants not only have, or it is not essential to know only the morphology or external features of the organism. There are various internal features of organisms that we have to understand. So morphology mainly helps to know the other aspects of the plants. What are the other aspects of the plants? They may be study of internal structure of the plant, or they may be study of the hereditary characteristics of the plant. So morphology also helps to know the various aspects of plants, like anatomy, genetics, etc. Anatomy, study of internal structure, genetics, etc. So if we know the morphology, with the help of the morphological features, we can also try to understand the internal characteristic features like anatomy, genetics, etc. Then, morphology is very helpful to study about the deficiency and toxicity of mineral nutrients on plants. Okay? So, if we know the morphology of any of the plants, we can identify by noting down the morphological changes. You know that sometimes the plants undergo morphological changes. It may be like wilting of leaf, stunted growth of the plant. So they are the morphological changes. So if we know the morphology of a particular plant, we can study about the deficiency and toxicity of mineral nutrients. So how can we identify whether the plant has deficiency of any of the nutrients or whether the plant has toxicity of any of the nutrients? Deficiency of mineral nutrient is the nutrients that are available in less amount than the required amount. Toxicity is the nutrients that are obtained to the plant that more than the required amount. It leads to toxic condition or toxicity. So we can identify by knowing the or by observing the morphology of a plant that whether the plant has toxicity of any of the mineral nutrients or whether the plant has deficiency of any of the mineral nutrients. So how can we observe or how can we identify this particular toxicity or deficiency? Mainly by noting down the morphological changes. Okay, by noting down morphological changes. We can identify the deficiency symptoms or toxicity symptoms of plants. Then, it is essential to know the morphology of plants mainly to understand about the structural adaptations of plants to their environment. You know that plants grow in wide range of habitats. They may grow in very cold climatic or colder regions. They may grow in the region where there is moderate temperature, or they may grow in a region where there is very high temperature. So plants will get adapted to that particular prevailing environmental conditions. Wherever they grow to the prevailing environmental conditions, the plant get adapted. So during this adaptation of plants to the environmental changes or to the prevailing environmental condition, sometimes there may be modification in their size and structure. Okay, there may be modification in their structure, or there may be modification in the size of any of the plant parts. So such a variation of structure of a plant part is known as modification or structural adaptations. Okay, so if we know properly or if we have a proper knowledge of morphology, we can identify that such a plant has undergone structural adaptation. So we can also note down why the structural adaptation has taken place, because of what particular environmental condition the structural adaptation has been taken. Okay, so morphology, the knowledge of morphology is very, very important to know all these aspects. So if we know or if we have a proper knowledge of morphology, we can identify various aspects. We can identify the plant, we can classify the plants, we can know about the variations among the species, we can know about various aspects of plants like anatomy and genetics, and it is easy to study about the deficiency symptoms and toxicity symptoms of plants, and it is easy to understand about the structural adaptations of plants. Okay, so now let us discuss about the morphology of flowering plants. We know that flowering plants are called as angiosperms. In the previous chapters, we have discussed that kingdom Plantae has been divided into 5 different divisions. Among these 5 divisions, there is one such division known as angiospermae, which includes angiosperms or the flowering plants. So flowering plants are called as angiosperms. Even among the angiosperms, there is wide range of differences, or there are lot of variations or large diversity is seen among the angiosperms. Even the angiosperms also show a large diversity. Okay, angiosperms also show or exhibit wide range of diversity, especially in their structures. They show diversity in their structure. And you know that angiosperms have got a well-defined root, stem, leaves, flowers and fruits. Okay, all the angiosperms, they have or they bear roots, well-defined roots, stem, leaves, angiosperm. Suppose if you uproot any of the plant, it may be a weed or any of the plant, you can observe that they have got a definite root system as well as shoot system. Okay, and you have to remember that majority of the plants, there are different types of plants, you know that there are algae, bryophytes, gymnosperms, pteridophytes as well as angiosperms. Among these, more than 50% of the plants that are found in our biosphere or on earth, they are angiosperms. So there are some shows definite root system and shoot system. Angiosperms have definite root system and shoot system. Root system and shoot system. So what is a root system? Root system is a non-green part of a plant body or non-green part of a plant axis which grows underground. Okay? Root system is non-green part of a plant body which grows underground and it usually grows positively geotropic. Okay? It grows underground. It is non-green part of a plant axis and it grows positively geotropic. Positively geotropic. Now, what is a shoot system? Shoot system is that particular part of a plant axis which grows above the ground level. It grows above the ground level. It is green in color. It undergoes or it has got certain photosynthetic parts and it grows negatively geotropic or positively phototropic. Shoot system is the part of a plant body that grows above the ground level. Above the ground level. They grow negatively geotropic. Negatively geotropic or positively phototropic. Positively phototropic. They are the green parts of a plant body. They are generally green in color and they undergo photosynthesis. So these are some of the basic differences between root system and shoot system. And you know that we have already discussed that the angiosperms, they are found in wide range of habitats. They are found in wide range of habitat and they vary in size. Okay, they vary widely in their size. They may be small microscopic or they may be the tallest plants. So, hope you remember those plants, angiosperms which are very small and microscopic. The angiosperm that is small and microscopic is Ulfia. Microscopic plant is Ulfia. Okay. And which is that angiosperm that grows to a tallest height or tallest angiosperm? We have studied this in the previous class under plant kingdom. That is Eucalyptus rechnens. Eucalyptus rechnens is the tallest plant. And there are certain angiosperms which grow very wider. So, widest angiosperm is Ficus bengalensis. Ficus bengalensis is the widest angiosperm. So, it usually produces branches such that it usually covers around 2 to 5 acres of land. So, it can spread to around 2 to 5 acres of land. Okay? So, that is the widest angiosperm. Smallest angiosperm, tallest angiosperm and widest angiosperm. So, next let us discuss about various organs in the angiosperms and we have to study about each part of a it may be vegetative part of an angiosperm or reproductive part of an angiosperm. Now, let us discuss about the parts of flowering plants. You know that different structures are born on plant axis. Plant has got a definite axis. The plant axis is differentiated into two systems, the root system and shoot system, and different parts are borne on the plant axis. So based on the different parts that are borne on the plant axis, different structures that are borne on plant axis there are two different kinds of organs. We usually consider these structures which are present on the plant axis as organs. They are called organs. So organs of plants may be of two different kinds. They may be vegetative organs. They may be vegetative organs or reproductive organs. Vegetative organs, or they may be reproductive organs. So some of the vegetative organs of plants are root, stem, and leaves. These are the vegetative parts of the plant. The reproductive parts of the plant are flowers, fruits, and seeds. Flowers, fruits, and seeds. So in this particular chapter, we have to study both about vegetative parts as well as reproductive parts of a flower or the plant axis or angiosperms. Okay? So these two are the parts or organs of the plants, vegetative organs and reproductive organs. So in this particular chapter, we are going to study in detail about the vegetative organs like root, stem as well as leaves, their functions and modifications. And we are also going to study about the reproductive organs of a angiosperm or the flowering plant, that may be flowers, fruits and seeds, as well as their structures and